Hey guys, I'm Jack and I make immersive 3D websites using Spline, Webflow and GSAP. And today, what I want to do is talk about how to make realistic textures using Spline so that you can make your 3D assets look pretty photorealistic. Let's dive in. Here's what we'll be making today. We're going to be making this interlocking rings, which look pretty realistic, I would say. Like, we've got this interesting texture overlaying it. We've got what looks like a lighting effect, which is actually no lights pointing at this. You can see in here that there's no directional light. This is all done using textures and layering in Spline. So what we've got here is we've got a MatCap effect making it shine. Don't know why I said that so weird. Shine. Then we've got an image of this metal under here. And then we've got this bump map, which basically gives it this effect used with the lighting. You can see here it says bump map, which is targeting this image, and intensity is 10. And it creates this mad effect here. So it might look like I've got actual, you know, displacement of the material. Actually, this is just an overlay. Now, the massive advantage of this is that the file size is quite small in comparison to what it would be if it was using displacement. You can actually displace stuff quite easily. Whoop. If I just show you quickly now, if we change this to displace on the bottom, we can actually create something where, you know, a blob. You can see here how this blob is changing shape as I make this massive. In fact, why don't I just do this using an actual shape? If I get a big sphere, and then what I do is, let's give it a material, so I'm going to change this to that, say, and then I add a displacement layer. I can actually change this massively by actually changing the geometry of the shape, right? But this is not changing the geometry with a bump map, it's actually just making it look like the geometry is different. Hope that makes sense. Let's dive in. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new file. I'm going to call this rings demo. Now, when you open a file in Spline, you've got a rectangle and you've got directional light. We're just going to delete both of them right now. I'm going to change the background of this scene by clicking on the background, and then there's background color here. I'm just going to make this nice and easily viewable for you guys by changing this white. Now, we're going to click plus, go down to rectangle, and we're going to draw a big rectangle. Now, you can do this by actually just clicking R and then just drawing a rectangle, but now you know, you can do that yourself. Okay, I'm going to click convert to path. Boom, I've got a path made. 3D rectangle in the building. Now, say I want this to be a little bit roundy schmoundy. I'm going to click on corners and I'm just going to round that up, maybe 60. And then I'm going to go down to here, maybe make the size of this a little bit bigger. Let's make these all 60. That's all fine. Flat, round, this is all good. You can do all sorts of fun things. You can twist it if you so fancy. You can change the scale to start and stop at different points. I'm actually just going to keep this at one so that we've got a consistent ring around here. If you hold Alt and then click and drag your mouse, you can see that this is a 3D object. It's in line, it's what we want. It's all good to be played with. Now, how do you get textures on your object. Well, first of all, click your object and you'll see that this panel changes down here. And then we've got this material section. Now you've got automatically color and you've got lighting. If we change the color, pretty self-explanatory. We can change the lighting here. We've got different types of lighting. We've got Lambert, Phong, Physical, and Tune. Now, we want to keep it at Phong, which is the default. And what we're going to do is we're going to add an image. So we're going to click the plus, and then we're going to click on this little arrow here and click on Image. Now, ooh, that's super ugly. We've just got this effect now. Now, what a lot of people don't realize is that you can actually upload your own images to this. You think, oh, I've just got these default libraries here. None of them are really metal. I don't really know how to make it metal. Don't fear, cowboy. What you can do is you can click the plus and you can actually upload your own images here. Now, how do you get an image of metal? Well, you can go on the internet and type in metal and try and find an image. But what I recommend you doing is actually downloading a pack, which I've previously got, called MatCap Mega Bundle from Cosmo Labs. They do all sorts of cool different effects and stuff. But if you buy this for, what is it? $39.99 is what I paid for it. There are so many different MatCaps overlays that you can do, and it just makes your spline so much better. So I recommend getting that. Link in the show notes if you guys want that. Okay, so we're back here. We're going to click Replace Image, and we're going to go to Metals on the Cosmo Labs offering. Again, you can try and like do this without downloading the Cosmo Labs. You could just type in metal and try and get like a metal texture. But here's one that I'm going to use. So it's number 11 in the metal pack if you buy this pack. And now we've got this overlay. Now already it's got what looks like some kind of a texture, but I think we could amp this up to really make it look a little bit more realistic. So we've got this image on the top, we've got lighting, we've got color. Since this image is 100, none of this lighting even shows. If I turn this down to 50, you'll see that we've got a kind of light blue effect, but we don't want the blue at all, so we can just get rid of that. But we want to keep the lighting. Okay, now this is an important part. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this circle next to the lighting, and you'll see that we have bump map down here. Now, currently it says none. What we can do is we can click on the random numbers that are below. That's just the name of the image that I've uploaded of the metals. And then we've got intensity here, and we've also got shininess. You'll see that these options have now shown up. So let's say we change this to 10. And let's say we change the shininess up too. Now you're like, yeah, Jack, I don't really see any different. Well, hold your horses there, cowboy. If we now put a MatCap overlay on top of this, boom, you'll see how cool this is. You'll see this textured effect that we've just created. Now, like I said, we haven't changed the geometry here. All we've done is we've basically artificially made this texture using the bump map feature in Spline. And you're like, yeah, cool, Jack. Like, why is this weird green texture now overlaying it? I don't want that. We want the metal effect. Fair play, cowboy. If we go back to the materials panel here, so if we click on our object, and then we'll scroll down to materials, what we need to do is we need to change this MatCap to overlay. Now we're cooking. So what we've done is we've got the shininess of the MatCap. In fact, we can even get a shinier one here. Boom. That's looking quite cool. You can play around with this yourselves, guys, but I'm going to choose the shiniest of the shines. And we've changed that to overlay. Now we've got a pretty interesting textured effect. Look at that. And that's just a few clicks. A few clicks. Madness. Okay, so Let's play around with this effect. So if we click on the image, and we can change the scale of it, so we can just do that, or we might be able to offset it slightly. Play around with this, because the subtlest of touches can completely change how realistic yours looks and feels. If we go to the lighting layer, we can change the shininess, we can change the intensity. If you turn the intensity up, what you're doing is you're essentially creating a more weathered looking clip here. You're creating a very intensely weathered little clip. Don't know if that looks more realistic or less realistic. I guess it depends what we're going for. Looks pretty cool either way. What I actually think I'm going to try and do is make it less. Let's try that. Whoop. So let's turn that down to, say, 5. I think that actually looks better, don't you guys? Well, I know you can't respond because this is a YouTube video, but I think that looks better. Okay, cool. So we've got something that looks pretty realistic. Now we want to make it interlocking. So if we copy this whole thing, we click Command-C and Command-V, you'll see that we've got rectangle, rectangle 2. Let's change this to clip. And let's change this one to clip 2. Now, clip 2, what we're going to do is we're going to rotate it, which we can do very easily by clicking on clip 2, and then you'll see that this this little modal will pop up, and then you can rotate using the green one. Now, if we want to rotate it 45, we can just click that. And then maybe we want to bring it up so that the top is just touching there. Great stuff. Now we've got something that looks pretty damn realistic. If we change the background to dark, you'll see we've got something that's pretty cool. Let's actually change this to 90 rather than 45. And bang, we've got something that looks pretty realistic and cool. Now, say you wanted multiple different clips here. Well, first of all, let's make sure that we've nailed the material. Let's just change the intensity one more. Let's just keep playing with this. Maybe let's do 15, you know. I think 15 is pretty cool. Yeah, I'm going to keep it 15. Okay, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click these 4 dots here next to material, and I'm going to click the plus. And what I've done is I've created a material that I can then apply to anything else I make. So clip material is what I'm going to call that. Now the top one, I need to apply that same material to. So I'm going to click on these 4 dots and then bang. And there it is, guys. We've got a pretty realistic looking clip, which we can then use in our designs. If you wanted to do more with these, you know, say you were like, okay, now let's clone them. You can just click the cloner tool here, get a load of them by changing the count. And you can change the position of them, you can change the scale, you can randomize them, and there's a lot more that you can do. But actually, what we could try is turning this in, oop, not that one. We could change this to a grid, do some quite interesting things with the design here. I mean, all sorts of different things that you could do to create, like interlocking chains, or, you know, all sorts. That's going to be another video, though. That has been looking at bump map, making photorealistic textures, and creating something that doesn't look super heavy on your website, but, you know, you could do some quite cool things recording. Maybe recording different videos for products or anything which has textures that you're applying to. Hope that helps, guys. And, you know, really cool. doesn't involve loads of light, it's not super heavy, and it means that you don't need to have loads and loads of polygons in your design by using the displacement feature. Hope that helps. Ciao.